They call you the human cannonball, but you're really more of a pinball person. Your act involves flying through a dozen rings of fire, bouncing through a trampoline course, and catching the trapezist in the grand finale. Your cannon has metal coils that accelerate you to the perfect speed. At least it's supposed to. Today's pre-flight test fails dramatically, and upon inspection, this is a clear act of sabotage. Someone amped the power up to the max. It's too late to abort the launch. The trapezist will plummet if you don't catch him in a few minutes, so you'd better get fixing. The cannon was invented by your eccentric mentor, and as usual, his instructions leave something to be desired. The cannon's electromagnet is powered by energy cells located in 16 chambers on 2 levels. Each level is a hollowed-out square with 3 chambers to a side. The acceleration is survivable if there are twice as many energy cells in the upper level as in the lower level. Every chamber has 1 to 3 energy cells, and each side of the cannon made of 6 chambers has 11 energy cells. Your mentor designed the cannon to use a certain number of energy cells, but when the shipment arrived, it was 3 short. So he made all of those conditions work with this reduced number, and it fired perfectly. That's the amount you'll need. Too many or too few, and you and the trapezist are doomed. How many energy cells should you use, and where? The first step in this puzzle is to narrow the options. Let's focus on Rule 3 in isolation. We could put 11 cells in these 2 corners and fulfill it with just 22 total cells, because adjacent sides share corners. But if we put 11 in the middle chambers, we could have 44 cells. The answer must be in the range bounded by those extremes. We can use the other rules to refine our options further. Since there are twice as many cells in the upper level, the total cells must be a multiple of 3. Now, because of Rule 4, we need to find 2 consecutive multiples of 3 that can meet all the conditions. Up to this point, we haven't used the rule that each chamber must have 1 to 3 cells. It tells us that the minimum for the lower level is 8 cells, in which case, by Rule 1, the upper level would have 16. On every side, the lower level would account for 3 of the 11 cells, so the upper would have to have 8. But if 2 opposite sides had 8, that would be the upper level's entire 16, not leaving any for these 2 chambers. So 24 is out. Let's look at the other extreme. The upper level can have at most 3 times 8, or 24 cells, which would give a total of 36. That eliminates 39 and 42. With 36, if we had 3 cells in each chamber, each side of the upper level would already have 9 of its 11 cells, meaning we'd have to leave empty chambers on the lower level. So 36 is also out. What about 33? We know we don't want any sides with all 3s, so we can place 2s at opposite corners of the upper level. Now we have 8 of 11 cells per side, so we could place exactly 1 cell in each lower chamber, but that would fall short of the lower level's required 11. That leaves only 2 options, 30 and 27, which must work by process of elimination, and 27 is the one you should use. To total 9, the lower level must have 7 ones and 1 2. If you put the 2 in a middle chamber, the upper level would have too many cells. So the 2 has to go into a corner, and you can then place the upper level like this. You've barely snapped the last energy cell into place when you hear the ringleader announcing your act. You're pretty sure you've also noticed enough clues to solve the mystery. Who sabotaged you? If you love to tinker, invent, and experiment, Brilliant has a cool scientific thinking course you may be interested in. For instance, check out this lesson on the center of mass. In it, you're trying to balance mobiles, you can shift around the balance points and immediately see how the mobile balances or doesn't. This course features tons of interactive exercises that'll let you experience the principles of science firsthand. Visit brilliant.org/TED-Ed to try it out, and the first 833 of you to use that link will receive 20% off the annual premium subscription fee.